Up until now, all my examples have dealt with equations where we get one or maybe two answers. But now this one deals with an inequality, all right? And so let me box that inequality. And so that tells me that the answer that we finally get from this example is going to be an entire set of solutions, all right? So just keep that in mind. I am not going to get, you know, x equals blah or x equals whatever. What I'm going to get, again, are intervals, okay? So how are we going to solve this inequality where we have fractions? Well, I ask myself, what are my denominators? My denominators are 2, 3, and 6. And if I, what could I multiply each of those by, each of those fractions, to get rid of a 2, a 3, and a 6? And hopefully all of you are thinking a 6, all right? And so I'm going to multiply every single term by 6. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to clean this up. We have 6 over 1 times x minus 4 over 2 greater than or equal to 6 over 1, x minus 2 over 3, plus 6 over 1, 5 over 6. Now, I've told you guys before, I don't expect you to write 6 over 1. The reason I do is so that no one who is inclined to multiply the 6 with the denominators does so. All right, again, we don't want those denominators getting bigger. We want them to go away. All right, and so how's that going to happen? The 2 goes into 6 3 times. The 3 goes into 6 2 times, and the 6 goes into 6 1 time. What does that leave me with? That leaves me with 3x minus 4 greater than or equal to 2x minus 2 plus 5. All right, and for right now, I'm not even going to worry about it that it's inequality. I'm just going to solve this like I did linear equations in the first chapter. All right, and so I'm distributing that 3 on the left. I distributed the 2 on the right. All right, I'm going to combine any like terms on each side that I can. All right, and so at this point, I have this linear inequality. All right, so how can I go about solving it? Well, I want to subtract 2x from each side, and I want to add 12 to both sides. That gives me x greater than or equal to 13. All right, and so for those of you that have forgotten how to write this, all right, if here's 0 on our number line and here's 13, all right, how am I going to graph this on a number line? Well, x is greater than or equal to 13. So that tells me I can be 13. All right, so I'm going to use a bracket, not parentheses, and I'm going to shade all the x's greater than 13. All right, this is our graphed solution. All right, and then I can also write in set notation this funny stuff right here. And let me read you the English. All right, this again, these are just the math symbols. All right, and it says the set, all right, and these two symbols, the X, oops, let me undo that. All right, this part right here, the set of all X such that X is greater than or equal to 13. All right, again, that's the set notation.